Hi everyone, today I am going to show how to draw aquarium. First I am drawing the table. I draw one line in the end of the sheet. You can leave 5 or 7 cm from the end of the sheet. This is for drawing table. Then I draw the other line and I join it. Then I draw the leg. See how I draw the aquarium. It's just a square or a rectangle on the table. Now I am going to draw the fish. Pay attention how I am drawing the fish. At the end of this video I will be showing step by step procedure for drawing fish. Here in this aquarium I have drawn 4 different fish. You can try any fish you like. I have arranged the fish in a simple manner. You can change the order where each fish can be placed. Either you can draw only 2 big fish and then you can draw many small fish. And remember, first spread a old newspaper and keep your sheet, art sheet or your art book on the newspaper. Then keep all your coloring materials on your right hand side. For that also spread a old newspaper and then keep all your coloring materials. And if you are using your left hand, keep everything on your left hand side. Always keep this in your mind whenever you are drawing. Each fish has different tail and fins. You should pay attention to the lines how I am drawing each tail and the fins. Each one is different. First, watch this video fully till the end and then start your work. And for the fish, you can leave small space where the mouth come and then you can draw the mouth or join it and draw a single line for the mouth. And always there will be a small space where the tail comes. You should not join where you are going to draw the tail. Most of the fish, the shape will be like a leaf, like a sleeping leaf, and where the tail comes there will be always a gap. The lines from the top and from the bottom, it won't join together. This small fish and drawing 3 together like a group. You can draw only 1 fish or 2 fish, or you can draw more like a 5 or 6 together. It's your choice because it's your aquarium. After drawing, mark everything with black marker. Again, use scale for outlining the aquarium and the table. After marking, always remember at least allow it to dry for 10 to 20 seconds and then erase the pencil line. If you draw with a black marker or sketch pen and if you erase immediately, it will smudge. And then here for drawing pebbles, I am not just drawing continuously. Pay attention, I am drawing each stone different. And while coloring this also, we are going to color each stone individually. And for this plant, in the aquarium, you can draw any shape you're comfortable with. And here I'm using an extra dark pencil to draw because for the visibility in the video, always you should use a plain HB pencil for drawing and always draw very light and don't use the eraser often. Now you can see how I arrange each fish in the aquarium. You can't draw too many fish, then it will look too crowded. So I just drawn four big fish and then small fishes. And always draw in different direction. Don't draw all the fish in one direction. And for coloring, I'm using orange and red for the cover. Be patient while you're coloring aquarium. Don't leave any space while you're coloring and please do remember coloring with direction. See, after giving red, I'm merging the two colors with orange again. I've given dark orange and red. And always remember, you should start from the top to bottom while you're coloring. So I started in the top with red and orange, then I'm giving light blue for the water. I'm giving in one direction. For the fish, you can just outline the blue and then you can start filling the gaps like this. Either your stroke should be in sleeping line or slanting line or standing line. You should not color the water till the end. You will color only till the half and then you will color the fish and then you will color blue again. Like that you will repeat the process slowly and neatly. You will give the coloring for the water. Now I have given blue only till here and then I am coloring the fish. Now here I am giving yellow and light green. This is medium yellow and light green. I am giving the color over here. See how I am merging the colors. First I am giving the light color, then I am giving the dark color, and then again I am using the light color to merge the dark color. I am using oil pastels here. If you use plastic crayons, you can't merge the colors. You can even use color pencils. fish, when you give two colors, it will be more attractive than single color. And remember, for the tail and fins, you can give two color, light color on the top and the dark color on the inside or on the end. And merge the colors neatly. And for this, I'm giving light purple and dark pink. Even for this fish, I'm giving two shades. Once you started giving color combination, you can't just use simple plain colors. Color combination will be more. Here I am giving dark violet and dark pink. The color combination will be more visibly attractive. For the kids, if you are doing this aquarium, please take a break in between. You can't do the whole thing at a stretch. Your fingers might pain by holding the crayons continuously. So take a break now and then and do the color slowly. Don't be in a rush. See how I'm filling blue in between the small fish. Even without giving the outlining with the blue, you can do the coloring like this. There should not be any white gaps. And when you are holding the crayons and coloring, please, the pressure should be same all over. You can't just press very hard at one end and suddenly you will give very light at the other end. Then the color will be, one side it will be dark and one side it will be light. So give while holding the crayons, give very slight pressure. Don't press so hard. And for this fish, I'm giving dark yellow and orange. Here also, for each fins and tail, I'm giving color separately. I'm not just rushing and merging everything together with one single stroke from the mouth to tail with one stroke yellow and then again orange down. Don't do like that. Pay attention, see how I'm coloring and you just imitate exactly. Now I'm merging the colors. For the small fish, for two fish I've given color combination. And the others are given single color. If you want, you can give color combination for the small fish or you can just give single color. And remember, when you are drawing, please draw big. Don't draw tiny fish. Then it will be very difficult for you to give color combination. Kids, whenever you are drawing, always draw big so that it will be easy for you to do the coloring and practice color combination. If it is too small, you can't practice color combination and merge the colors. See, again after that fish, I have given blue till this half. Now I am giving red. Here you can leave like this red and white for this fish. But I'm giving red, orange, light orange I'm giving here. I don't remember the names of the fish, so I'm just telling fish. slowly color it and then merge the colors. If you, especially when you're using crayons, if you color first, color all the fishes, then in the end, if you start coloring the water, your palm, this side near the pinky finger, that side of the palm, when you're holding the color, it will be pressing on the sheet. So naturally, when you start coloring in the end, if you start blue from the top, naturally your hands will be smudged on the, all over the fish, and the color will be spread in the sheet. By coloring like this way, your work will look excellent and you won't be smudging the color anywhere. The colors will look very fresh and your aquarium will look very beautiful. See, now for this leaf or grass, I'm giving light green and dark green, and then I'm merging the color with light green. Even for the other plant, I'm giving light green and dark green. Again, for the stones, I'll be giving separately, not with one stroke from this end to that end, one color and then the other color. Now I'm filling the blue at the bottom. And I'm even giving little bit dark blue at the end. Just very lightly I'm giving dark blue. For this fish, I'm giving black lines and gray in between. You can either give gray or just leave it like this. Just draw the lines and leave it. I'm giving gray for the pebbles or stones, and then I'm going to give black on the top. I'm giving the light color on the bottom. I'm giving the dark color. Always, whenever we are coloring any plant or flower, anything, the lighter color will come on the top and the darker color will come at the bottom. And for the table, I'll be giving yellow ochre and brown. And for the leg of the table, I'll be giving only dark brown. At the end of this coloring, I'll be showing step-by-step procedure for each fish. Now I'm giving yellow and brown. Now I'm merging the color with the lighter tone. Now for the leg, I'll give it dark brown. Now this is your aquarium. Now, this is for the simple fish. If you can't draw, just draw one line in the center, then draw like a leaf, ulta leaf. I've given in different color for you to understand. And see the tail, how the lines are given. One is like a C and one is like, it is covered like this. Then see, pay attention to the tail in this fish. I've given different types over here. I've shown you can choose any type. This is again like a V. Again, this is like a V, and I'm drawing two lines inside. And here also pay attention to the tail. How I've drawn the curve. Again, this one will be like a leaf. So each one I've used different, for each step I've used different color sketch pen for you to understand. Again, pay attention to the tail and the fin how I've drawn. And remember, when you are practicing, please use pencil. Don't use sketch pens for drawing. It's only for marking the outline of any picture or the border lines. See how the lines are drawn for the fin and the tail. I've even shown for the tail separately how to draw. And for this fish, the tail will be a little bit lengthier. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe. Thank you.